When you start thinking about digging a well, it is essential to consider several factors, and one of the most important is to search for an area with an abundant supply of groundwater. Evaluate the local geology and topography to select the best location for drilling. Some areas may have fewer rock formations or soil that is suitable for easy well drilling. Look for an area with soil that has good water-absorbing capacity. Before starting the process of drilling a well, it is necessary to determine the desired area to be excavated. Manual drilling requires physical strength and continuous manual efforts. It may take longer and require strenuous work and precision in directing the strikes to achieve satisfactory results. The drilling process must be done with accuracy and guidance to avoid injury and ensure the success of the drilling operation. In the early stages of the drilling process, it is difficult to determine the exact depth required to reach the groundwater. This is due to the variation in soil types and rock formations in different locations. When drilling begins, an initial estimation is made for the depth that is believed to be suitable for reaching the groundwater. As drilling progresses over time, the progress is monitored and samples taken from the borehole are evaluated. Based on the initial assessments and information obtained from the samples, the final depth is determined, which is believed to achieve access to the groundwater. Consultation with drilling specialists or well engineers may also be sought for additional guidance and more accurate estimations. Amateur drillers and professional contractors often rely on previous experience and local knowledge in the area to determine the estimated depth needed to reach the groundwater. Continuous monitoring and evaluation of the samples taken during the drilling process are also required to ensure accuracy and achieve the desired goal of the drilling. Can access to groundwater be achieved as a result of the drilling process? The aim of the drilling process is to access groundwater. When a well is drilled to a depth that reaches the aquifer layers, water can be extracted from those layers. However, it should be noted that accessing groundwater depends on the required depth and the availability of water in the aquifer layers in the specific area. There may be variations in the quantity and quality of water in different areas, so local studies and analyses must be conducted to determine the best drilling location and estimate the appropriate depth to access groundwater. Remember that drilling itself does not guarantee the presence of an adequate quantity or suitable quality of groundwater. How long does it take to drill a well? The duration of drilling a well varies greatly and depends on several factors. Some of these factors include required depth of the well. If the well needs to be drilled to a significant depth, it may take a longer time to complete the drilling process. Soil type and geological formation. If the soil is hard or compacted, or if the drilling encounters solid rocks, it may take more time to penetrate and drill the well. Equipment used. The use of powerful and efficient drilling equipment can reduce the drilling time. Weather and environmental conditions. The impact of weather conditions, such as rain, snow, or unstable ground, can affect the speed of progress in the drilling process. In general, drilling a well can take from several days to several weeks, and it may require even more time in certain special cases. It is a process that requires patience and attention to detail to ensure satisfactory results and the creation of an efficiently functioning well for extracting groundwater. Installing pipes and fittings. Once the desired depth is reached in the drilling process, the drilling pipes and necessary equipment are installed in the well. These pipes play a crucial role in strengthening the well's structure and maintaining the straightness and stability of its walls. The pipes are designed to withstand the pressure exerted by the surrounding soil and groundwater, preventing the collapse of the well's sidewalls. The drilling pipes used in the process are designed in a way that allows the groundwater to flow into the well without any undesired external leakage. Water-resistant pipes and sealing materials are utilized to prevent the penetration of groundwater into the gaps between the pipes and the surrounding soil. In summary, the installation of drilling pipes and necessary equipment is a crucial step in the drilling process. It contributes to the reinforcement of the well, prevents the collapse of sidewalls, and ensures the availability and proper direction of water in a safe and efficient manner. The process of lowering the well casing into the well requires concentration and physical effort. The workers involved in the casing installation need to perform their tasks with precision and caution, as they are responsible for lifting and moving heavy casing sections and securing them in the proper position inside the well. The process of lowering the well casing can be physically demanding due to the heavy loads, repetitive movements, and working in tight spaces. The use of tools and equipment such as cranes and ropes may be necessary to facilitate the casing installation. In addition, working during the well casing installation requires compliance with safety procedures and wearing appropriate protective equipment such as helmets, gloves, and safety glasses. Workers should also be trained in proper techniques for movement and lifting to minimize the risk of injuries resulting from fatigue and physical strain. In summary, the process of lowering the well casing into the well requires concentration and physical effort from the participating workers and adherence to safety procedures and the use of appropriate protective equipment to ensure the safety of the operation. What does the flow rate of water from a well depend on? The flow rate of water from a well depends on several factors, including the depth of the well, the quality and quantity of the rock formation, the pressure system, the presence of other wells in the area, and the pumping and pressure equipment used. Additionally, the flow rate of water from a well can be affected by other factors such as the groundwater level, the composition of the surrounding soil, and the condition of the well itself, such as the diameter of the well and any obstructions or blockages in the well system. Furthermore, the geological nature of the area and climatic factors can also influence the flow rate of water. In general, the flow rate of water depends on a balance between water storage in the aquifer layers and the rate of recovery of water in the well. Initial estimates of the flow rate can be made based on geological data and available information, but the actual flow rate can be more accurately determined after the drilling process is completed and well testing is conducted.